How you doing, everybody? Randy Richard in the shop. Continuation of part two of the Hemingway Kits compact rotary broach. So in the first part, we built the locking ring. This is going to be part two, following right along with their instructions. Their written instructions, right? So we did the locking ring. Now it's time for the shank. The shank of the part is part number two. This is part number two right here. Part number two right there. And the detail of part number two is right here in this boxed in area right there. Oops, there we go. And here's the completed part. Actually, there's a little slot in it, two holes, and those are counterboard. So we'll let's go over the lathe. Let's make this part.
Our material is 2.5 inches long. The part's going to be approximately 1.5 inches long, and we'll need at least some distance there between the chuck and the part to part it off. And so we'll have about 1/2 inch here to chuck it up. I'm going to use a 6-jaw chuck here. And they say the concentricity of this part is not real critical, but you know, you always want to have those parts concentric. Now there is a little slight burrs on these edges because they're just saw cut, but I don't think that's going to matter right this minute. So I'm going to put this piece in there at my 1/2 inch. We'll start off here, we'll face it off. I'm down here. 1.25 inches is the rough measurement, a little over 1.25 inches. That's inches. We're going to turn it down to 0.394. That's what we were looking for. I'm just going to do a skim cut here, so I know this is concentric with that, and then we're going to part it off. And I just a touch chamfered these ends. We come down about 8 millimeters, and we're going to part it off. Now we're going to remount it, face it, do a little slot and a couple holes.
Mill, little V-block, it's on sitting on a big 1/2 inch thick parallel here. We're going to do a, they say it called for a 4mm slot, but I'm going to do 5/32. That's within a thousandth of 4mm. Slot half a millimeter deep right across the middle. I used the edge finder to find the center, and we'll just go across. Kind of hard to see it, kind of bright, but there you go. Now we need to put some holes and counterboards. We need to
put two holes in here. I'm going to go with a number 29 drill. These are 3mm screws. These are pretty small. So I'm going to go with 29. They say placement is essentially accurate. Needs to be accurate. So in the middle of the groove, left and right, so I haven't moved my position at all from milling, and 16mm apart, 16.5mm apart. So I'm over halfway already. And we're gonna spot drill and then drill. And these holes go all the way through. Now we gotta flip this over and counterbore on the other side. I enlarged these holes to a number 24 drill so I can use my number 6 screw counterbore, because we're coming in from the back side here, and this is pretty close to what we need anyway, maybe a little bit big, but I can get this in here. So I'm just using the drill to align the hole. Then we'll do the counterbore. Make sure we have enough. Oh boy, that's. It's going to be tight in there. All counterboard. There's the counterbars. Parts ready to go. Just blow out the chips, but our net, it's done. Part number 2. Thank you guys. Thanks for watching.